A common discussion in economics is, how is the economy doing? It's a difficult discussion to have because oftentimes we don't really clarify what it is that we're looking at to judge whether or not the economy is being effective. In our class, in our course, what we look at or isolate are four specific objectives that a good economy will be keeping in balance. These four objectives, it's pretty hard to say that you're doing well at all of them all at the same time. And that'll be a little bit of what we discuss here. We're going to go into each one of these four in depth later on in later videos. For now, this is just a general overview. So the first objective is that unemployment in the country is low. And it's not just that there's a high quantity of jobs, but you want to make sure that people are doing the jobs that they are trained for. So you don't want to see, for example, somebody who's an engineer working as a working as a retail salesman or salesperson or something like that. And that is specific to the workforce. And remember, that's a smaller group of people than the entire population. The second objective is that you want inflation, that is price levels in the country. You want it to grow at a low and stable rate. Do note that we're not looking for deflation. We don't want the price level to decline. And we don't even want it to be zero. We do want some small amount of inflation for stability. Deflation is a little bit like Santa Claus. It doesn't exist. I hope that's not a surprise to you. And then again, like I said, a little bit of inflation is good because it provides a bit of stability and predictability to the economy. These two in particular tend to sort of fight against each other. That is, if you have low unemployment, then most people are going to be employed. Most people are going to have jobs, which means that it's likely that price levels are going to be driven up because there's going to be increased levels of aggregate demand in the country. And vice versa, if there's no inflation, if there's no price levels going up, it's unlikely that unemployment will be very low because probably you're in a recession. That's kind of what we see in the Phillips curve, the short run version of the Phillips curve. We've talked about that before in class. There's also a video. You might go look at that too. The second two objectives, or the third and fourth objectives, they kind of also are somewhat related to each other. The third is economic growth, so we want to see real output in the country, remember, independent of price level. We want to see an increase, and we've shown that already, or talked about that already in a lot of different models. This, however, is the first time that I'm really going to specifically mention the idea of development. The fourth topic in IB economics is the topic of economic development. And the idea there is, how do we get LDCs, less developed countries in the world, how do we help them progress? So that's a major focus of the course, so it's worth pointing out now that economic growth is different than economic development. We pretty much assume that economic growth is a prerequisite for economic development. There's a few exceptions, but for the most part it is. However, we've seen a lot of economic growth without economic development. So economic development means improvement in the living standards of a given country. We measure it most often with the HDI, that is the Human Development Index, but that's just one way that we might measure it. The fourth goal is equity in the distribution of income. Keep in mind this word equity is different than equality. Equality would be the situation we see here, where two people are making the exact same amount of money. That's equality. Equity could be this situation, where this person works 10 hours and that person works 5 hours. So since they work twice as much, they make 200 to this person's 100. They make twice as much money. We can argue that that is equitable. That's an easy way to see equity. A more complex way to see equity and more realistic to the world in which we live is this situation where one person has created a business, a good, an idea, and it's another person who puts it together. And if we're going to take the same $300, well, what's the proper split? It's probably not that, and it might not even be this, but should it be 299 to 1? Should it be $299.99 to 1 cent? Oftentimes, it's too close to that. So this discussion about equity is very tough. It's always going to be a normative discussion. It's always going to be qualitative. it's always going to be very hard to say what's the right amount. What should the person who has created all the jobs for everyone else, well, what should they get paid? How much is fair? Nonetheless, we do accept this as a goal. More equity is probably a good thing. I don't think too many people disagree with that statement. These two can be kind of in opposition against each other. That is, oftentimes, especially in LDCs, when we do see a lot of economic growth, if it's not going to be economic development, the one example or the one option I did give, oftentimes the reason is we see economic growth in a country, and what we see is a growth in inequity in the country and in the distribution of income. So in an LDC, it tends to be a common problem that economic growth will drive inequity. Again, here in South Africa, we see we're amongst the highest countries in the world as far as inequity in the distribution of income goes. So these two can be somewhat against each other as well.